GPT-5 is finally here. Sam Altman and the team just dropped the most powerful AI model ever. GPT-5 is insane at coding. You give it a task, it writes the code, shows you how it looks and works right there in the chat, straight up magic. It's rolling out to everyone, free and pro users. And get this, you can fully customize it, colorful charts, Gmail and calendar integration, and even an endless voice mode, so you can just talk to it like you're chatting with a friend.
You are busy, so I'll keep it quick. Here are the most useful AI updates lately. Photoshop just dropped a cool update. In the beta, there is a new feature called Harmonize. Honestly, it feels like a cheat code. AI automatically adjusts colors, shadows, and lighting so everything matches perfectly with the background. Runway released Aleph. Think Photoshop, but for video. You can change backgrounds, add or remove objects, and even change clothes on characters. Plus, it can generate the same scene from different angles, and create the next frame in the same style. AI video tools are going crazy this year. Hard to believe that just a couple of years ago, things looked like so basic. By the way, I made a separate video where I tested all the top AI video generators. No hype, just what they can actually do. Now, VS3 can understand visual prompts. You upload an image, draw right on it to show what should move and where, and boom, it happens. Looks like magic. And one more cool thing in VS3. Box room. It turns a simple box into a full room. Super impressive. You can try it by yourself. Here is a sample prompt. Luma AI also launched a tool similar to Runway Aleph. It's called Modify with Instructions. You can now use text prompts to swap objects in a scene, change the background, tweak how character look, and even add effects like rain or snow. It looks super impressive, but folks on Twitter say it doesn't work quite as smoothly as polished examples on the site. As usual. Here is a big one. Your chats with a ChatGPT could actually be used in court. Sam Altman admitted that. Unlike with a real therapist or lawyer, conversations with a bot are not legally protected.
If you talk to a therapist or a lawyer or a doctor about those problems, there's like legal privilege for it. You know, like there's doctor-patient confidentiality. We haven't figured that out yet for when you talk to ChatGPT. So if you go talk to ChatGPT about your most sensitive stuff and then there's like a lawsuit or whatever, like we could be required to produce that.
So if OpenAI gets hit with a lawsuit, your chats can be requested, even if you deleted them. By company policy, chats are erased after 30 days, but they can be still preserved if required by law or for security reasons. So yeah, keep that in mind. And last week, there was another ChatGPT drama. User charts starting get it indexed by Google. Literally. If you have ever shared a link to your chart, it is treated as public, even if you have never posted that link anywhere. OpenAI said this was just a short experiment to help people discover useful conversations. Are you kidding me? I mean, I can kinda get why chats might be used in court, even if I hate it too, but indexing them, making them public, seriously? No way! Now OpenAI is rolling it back and starting to remove all those chats from Google Index, but you can find it still. Meanwhile, Figma just dropped a new tool called Make, a website generator. You give it a text prompt, it spits out a website prototype, then you can polish it in Figma. If you are expecting beautiful design, nope, it's not a polished Figma mockup. It's more like a functional React interface. Think of it as a quick way to show how things should work, not how they should look. So, if you need to throw together an idea and pitch it to a client fast, it's perfect. Google has something similar with Stitch, but honestly, I think Figma's version is better. Where's that magical make it pretty button? Zach just promised a personal superintelligence for everyone.
And our vision to build personal superintelligence for everyone.
Yep, forget metaverse, it's all about meta intelligence now. He dropped a whole manifesto saying the future is not about automating everything from the top down, but giving each of us our own AI assistant. And the main device? Smart glass for sure. So that's why he's been building that all-star AI team. I got it. Meta got the money, the infrastructure, billions of users, and a solid open source model. All that's left is to put it all together and boom. Meanwhile, Microsoft just revealed which job AI will replace first. They analyzed a bunch of Bing Copilot chats and came up with an AI applicability score, basically how vulnerable each job is to AI. So the most at risk: translators, historians, flight attendants, but who is gonna bring the food on the plane then? And the least at risk: machine operators, housekeepers, massage therapists. Basically, if it's hands-on, you're good. While everyone's busy making basic agents, Claude Code just dropped sub-agents. Basically, it's like having an entire IT team inside your AI, and each one with its own superpower. Think code reviews, debuggers, test runners, or even a data scientist. Claude Code just calls in whoever it needs based on context. So you just tell it what the agent should do, when to jump in, and what tools it's allowed to use. That's it. And here is the spicy part. Right before GPT-5 launches, Anthropic cut off OpenAI's access to their Claude API. Guess Claude Code must actually be that good. Honestly, I didn't even know that they were using each other's models. Apparently, OpenAI's engineers were running massive batches of coding, writing, and safety tests against Claude to tune their own GPT-5 candidates. Anthropic says, nope, that's against the rule, and you cannot use our API to build competing products. But OpenAI says that everyone does it, and by the way, Anthropic uses our API too. So let's see what happened. Meanwhile, OpenAI agent can now pass their I'm not a robot capture without breaking a sweat. Finally, no more hunting for traffic lights and bridges. So what's the next capture even gonna be? Dumb enough for humans, but hard for AI. Maybe this one. Oh, and this one is wild. The OpenAI agent can literally find a docked boat for you. Give it access to a public controllable webcam and it will pan around, zoom in and spot the boat. In case you miss the boat. What is the case? Google also rolled out a killer new feature in the United States Gemini subscriptions. Your AI assistant can now call businesses, talk to a real human, confirm prices, and stuff like that. Too bad it's only available in the United States. The other day, I actually had to call Universal Studio Japan. Yes, I had to be there, but I broke my leg. The team behind the music AI Suna just launched an infinite AI radio called Radio. The twist? The playlist is fully AI generated and the listeners can vote on the genre of the next track. So don't be shocked if your chill or 5 beats for studying suddenly turn into country. See you.